Strong coffee. Item number, SCP-949. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-949 is to be completely submerged in liquid nitrogen at all times. Any personnel attempting to remove SCP-949 from its container of liquid nitrogen without proper clearance is to be terminated on site. No one below level 3 can handle SCP-949. SCP-949's containment cell is to be locked and guarded at all times. SCP-949's cell must be kept at a constant temperature of 12 degrees Celsius. Description: SCP-949 was recovered from a Starbucks coffee shop in Los Angeles, California. The owner, terminated, was using SCP-949 to create more of what is SCP-949, although the copies don't have the same refilling effect. SCP-949 is a standard 12-fluid-ounce Starbucks coffee cup, except that it has the words Ultra Strength printed under the logo. SCP-949 is always filled with coffee, and the coffee inside always remains a constant 11.45 fluid ounces. The coffee inside is always hot and steamy, although liquid nitrogen seems to cool it by about 17 degrees Celsius. When the liquid inside SCP-949 is consumed, it has an immediate awakening effect on the drinker. For 24 hours, the drinker is upbeat, energized, and more productive. The urine tests for the drinker remain normal, although the urine comes out steamy and warmer than normal. After the drinker consumes SCP-949's liquid, they cannot sleep under any circumstances. Sleeping pills, hypnosis, data expunged, all have no effect on the subject. All subjects experience the effects of sleep deprivation, aching muscles, hallucinations, hand tremors, irritability, memory lapses, and mild psychosis, eventually culminating into suicide after 3 to 4 weeks. Addendum: SCP-949 was administered to a sleeping subject. It seemed to have an opposite effect. Subject never awakened from his sleep and was diagnosed as comatose. Addendum: attempts to study SCP-949's composition have failed. It's also interesting to note that as SCP-949 gets warmer, it exhibits a luring effect on personnel. If SCP-949 becomes warm, even room temperature, personnel will attempt to remove SCP-949 from its container and drink it. We must again reiterate the importance of keeping SCP-949 submerged in liquid nitrogen.